In my today's tutorial, you will learn how to make this very beautiful and easy crochet table centerpiece or a mandala with a cute flower at the center. Hi, I'm Shabori from hookedinloops.com. I make various kind of crafts tutorials in my channel. So please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for getting notifications. And don't forget to like, share and comment. So let's begin. We will take a 4-ply acrylic yarn and a crochet hook of size 3 mm. We will take the yarn and make a magic circle at first. You will get the tutorial on my beginner's crochet classes in my playlist, so check them out. So the magic circle is ready. Now we will begin the round 1 with a chain 3. This chain 3 is the first double crochet of this round. Then in the magic circle we will be making 14 more double crochet stitches. So taking the first chain 3 as a double crochet, we are having a total of 15 double crochets in this round, that is chain 3 plus 14 double crochets. So we will quickly complete our 14 double crochet stitches, and when it's done we will pull the tail of the magic circle and close the magic circle. Then we will close this first round with a slip stitch in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this round in this manner, and we will begin the second round now. For the second round we will do a chain 3. This is the first double crochet of the second round. In the same third chain of the starting chain 3 of the last round we will be doing one double crochet stitch. So we did a chain 3 and a double crochet in the beginning. Then in the second loop of the following stitch we are doing two double crochet stitch. So two double crochet stitches are done. Then again in the second loop of the next stitch we are doing two double crochet stitches, and in this manner we will be doing two double crochet stitches in each and every stitch of this round in the second loop of the stitches. Okay, so once it's done we will complete this round with a slip stitch in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this round 2, as I'm showing you. Then we will begin the third round with a chain 3. This is again the first double crochet stitch of this round. Then in the following stitch we are doing two double crochet stitches in the second loop of the stitch. Then in the next stitch we are doing one double crochet stitch in the second loop of the stitch, and again in the following stitch we are doing two double crochet stitches in the second loop of the stitch. So this is the pattern, that is one double crochet followed by two double crochets in each and every stitches. We will follow this pattern and quickly complete this round, that is one double crochet followed by two double crochets in the stitches. Okay, so this round is also completed. Just complete this round with a slip stitch in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this round. We will begin the fourth round now. So for that we will do a chain 1. In the same stitch where you slip stitched, just do a single crochet there, followed by chain 6. So we will do chain 6. And then we will skip the next 4 stitches, and in the following stitch we will do a single crochet stitch in both the loop of that stitch, followed by chain 6 again, and again we will skip the next 4 stitches, and in the following stitch we will do a single crochet stitch, and we will repeat this pattern throughout this round, that is chain 6 followed by skipping the next 4 stitches, and then in the following stitch we will do a single crochet and again repeat. In this way we will quickly complete this round. At the end of this round, we will just do a slip stitch in the first single crochet stitch of this round. We will begin the round 5 by doing a slip stitch in the following chain 6 space, followed by a chain 1. In the same chain 6 space, we will do a single crochet stitch. Then we will do chain 8. And then we will do a single crochet in the next chain 6 space. Followed by chain 8. And we will do a single crochet in the next chain 6 space. And we will repeat this pattern, that is chain 8 and then single crochet in the adjacent chain 6 spaces. So this round is also completed. We will complete this round with a slip stitch in the first single crochet stitch of this round. We will proceed to round 6. For that, we will slip stitch in the first chain 8 space of the last round. Then a chain 1, and in the same chain 8 space we will do a single crochet. After that we will do chain 10. And then we will do a single crochet in the adjacent chain 8 space. And then we will do chain 10 again. And then single crochet in the adjacent chain 8 space and repeat this pattern. As usual, at the end of this round, we will do a slip stitch in the first single crochet stitch of this round, followed by a chain 1, and we will cut this yarn as we will do a color change in the 7th round. So we will begin the 7th round now with the pink colored yarn. So we will take the yarn and make a slip knot with it, and then we will insert the hook in it and we will slip stitch in any chain 10 space of the last round, followed by chain 3. This is the first double crochet stitch of this round. In the same chain 10 space, we will do 19 more double crochet stitches. That is chain 3 and 19 double crochet stitches in this first chain 10 space in the 7th round. Okay? After that, we will move on to the next chain 10 space and we will do 20 double crochet stitches there. In the same manner, we will be doing 20 double crochets in each and every chain 10 spaces remaining. At the end, we will do a slip stitch in the third chain of the starting chain 3 of this round. Just do a slip stitch there, followed by a chain 1, and we will cut the yarn as we will do a color change again. So for the color change, we will be taking the blue colored yarn again. So we will make a slip knot with it and insert the hook in it. Then we will slip stitch in any stitch, or rather the third chain of the starting chain 3 of the last round. And we will do a slip stitch there at first, followed by a chain 1, and in the same third chain of the starting chain 3 we will do a single crochet. We will do one single crochet stitch in each and every stitch of the last round, one by one, and quickly complete this round in the same manner. And at the end, we will do a slip stitch in the first single crochet stitch of this round. Followed by a chain one, and we will cut the yarn. So our pattern is completed. We will weave in the loose end. So the main mandala is ready. However, I decorated it with a small puff stitch flower at the center portion. You will get the tutorial on making this puff stitch flower in my old videos. And we will stitch the flower in the center portion. So our beautiful mandala or the centerpiece is ready, and it is looking really pretty and colorful and perfect decor material for your table or wall. I hope you liked this easy tutorial and it was easy for you to follow. If you like this tutorial, then please hit the like button, comment in the comment section for any queries, and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you and have a great day.